How are you everyone? Fine? Okay. Now, in our last lecture, we have completed our chapter number 15, that is probability. Today, we are going to start our chapter number 14, that is statistics. Now, very simple logic is there. What is statistics? The statistic is nothing but the collection, presentation, analysis, and interpretation of the numerical data. See here students, in our day-to-day life, we are getting so many informations, but all are in a rough format, which we directly cannot study or we cannot interpret any result from it. So here, the statistic is giving systematic study and presentation of this data. In day-to-day life students, for example, we can say, the record of last 5 years profit of a company. Then we can say population counting, national income counting. So everything is the data which we are collecting and studying. Here in this chapter, we are going to study about the three measures of central tendency of ungrouped data. First one is mean. It is denoted by x bar. Here x bar is equal to sigma xi or fi xi upon n. Mean is nothing but the average value of the data. Here students, data is of two types. First one is primary data. And another one is secondary data. Data which we collect through our own efforts. Okay, I am preparing any data. For example, as a teacher, I am preparing attendance register of the student. So for that, I will not get any data from outside or outsource. So to develop that, I have to put my own efforts and I have to prepare it. So this type of data is known as primary data. Now secondary data. Secondary data means data for preparing which I am getting ready-made material, or I am getting that data from any source like Google or newspaper or magazine. So direct data I am getting and I am utilizing that data for any particular task. So that type of data is known as secondary data. Yes, now other central tendency, that is median. Median is denoted by capital M. This is the mid value. Here students, we have to keep one thing in our mind. Whenever we are calculating sums of median, then first of all, we supposed to arrange all the data in ascending order. After that, we have to check whether our number of observations are even or odd. If number of observations are odd, then we will use the formula median is equals to n plus 1 upon 2 observation. Now if number of observations are even, then we will find out median by using formula n upon tooth observation plus n upon 2 plus 1th observation whole upon 2. So this way we will get median of the data. And last concept, that is median. Last concept, that is median. Median is nothing but the most frequently repeated number. So here, students, you can see we learn the concept of three measures of central tendency. This chapter is also very important from the point of view of your 10th standard also. So everyone pay attention here so that you get exact idea about the terminology of the chapter. Still we are going to discuss some more concept of this. Here range is another terminology regarding this chapter. What is range? So whatever data is given, students, we have to find out maximum number and minimum number, means highest number and lowest number out of the data, and then we supposed to subtract both of them, so we will get the range of that data. Here highest number minus lowest number whole upon 2. Yes, then group data and ungrouped data means, students, whatever number is given in a class, for example 5 to 10, 10 to 15, 15 to 20. So this way group is given. So this type of data is known as group data. And ungrouped data means discrete numbers are given. For example, 12, 13, 14, 15, this way. So this is known as ungrouped data. Now here, this number is known as lower limit. And this number is known as higher limit or upper limit. Now if I want to find out class mark or mid value of the class, that is my xi, then I can find it out by using formula upper limit plus lower limit whole upon 2. Second thing is that, students, class may be continuous or incontinuous. What is continuous class length? So here my upper limit and here my lower limit, if both are same, these two are same, These two are same. Then this is known as continuous class length. But if my data is this way, 5 to 9, 10 to 15 or 14, here 15 to 19. So if this type of data is given, then we can see here these two numbers are different. This is known as incontinuous class length. So students, whenever we are going to plot the graph of histogram or anything else, at that time continuous class length is required. And if it is given in continuous class length, then it doesn't matter, we can directly plot the graph. But if it is not given in a continuous class length, then what we supposed to do? Lower limit minus 0.5, upper limit plus 0.5. So it will become 4.5 to 9.5. Then here minus 0.5, here plus 0.5. So it will become 9.5 to 14.5. Again here minus 0.5, here plus 0.5. So it will become 14.5 to 19.5. So these ways, students, whenever continuous class length is not given, at that time we supposed to convert the given class length into continuous class length, and for that we apply this method, lower limit minus 0.5, upper limit plus 0.5. So these way whatever class we will get, that will be continuous class length. So here students, all these are the different terminologies which we learn regarding this statistics chapter. Now in your exercise 14.1, some questions are given that we are solving orally. In first question, it is given, give 5 examples of data that you can collect from your day-to-day life. So here students, number of girl students in our class, that is one type of data, or number of boys in the class, number of computer sets in my computer lab, so this is again the data. Then telephone bill of our house for last 2 years, number of students appear in the examination obtained from newspaper. Then our population counting also we can consider as a data. So these ways, students, these all are the different situation which is considered as a example of statistics or data in our day-to-day life. Now in your question number 2, it is given, classify the data. Whatever example we have taken in question number 1, in that we have to identify whether that is a primary data or secondary data. This concept we have already learned, primary and secondary data, which I am preparing by using my own efforts, that is a primary data, and data which I am using for getting that, I am using another resources, that is known as secondary data. So here in our question number 1, we have taken first example, that is number of girls students in our class. Definitely that I have to count and I have to find it out. So that is a primary data. Second example we have taken, that is the number of computer sets in our computer lab. That is again primary data. Telephone bills of our house for last 2 years. So for that what we supposed to do? We have to collect all these lights bill and we have to collect the data. So that is also again a primary data. Now second one is, next one is given, number of students appear in examination obtained from newspaper. So this data I am getting from newspaper. I am not putting my any efforts to collect the data, and that is why it is considered as the secondary data. Next example we have taken, that is population counting. So that data I can get from the National Survey Center. Yes, for that I need not to put any my own extra efforts for that. So that is also considered as the secondary data. So these way, students, in our example one, in our exercise 14.1, some situations and types of data we learn. Now next concept we will learn in our next lecture. Till that, keep doing practice, refer all these terminology. Have a nice time. Goodbye.
आभार.